in the room. I'm very certain you have the framework.
So sexuality education arms you with the knowledge and the skill to be able to make good decisions for your life. So you're going to make positive decisions based on the information that is given to you. So you know how to ward off or go against sexual violence, sexual exploitation. You can be able to identify those small issues to do with some of these topics, and you can be able to make a decision. If you suffer sexual violence, where do I go then? And right now, COVID-19 has escalated the numbers of teenage pregnancies. We see over, in the past 6 months, they have said that over 22,000 girls have reported for antenatal care alone. 22,000. That is because of COVID-19. So how do we allow these girls to manage their sexuality? It is through sexuality education. So it becomes key and pertinent that we begin to impart this knowledge at the earliest stage possible so that people can manage their sexuality. One of the elements of sexuality education is age appropriateness. So every category will have the correct information to give. So from 0 to 5, they'll have a category. Even when you look at the National Sexuality Education Framework, it is categorized in that particular way. When you look at maybe 5 to 10, they'll talk about issues of bad touches, things like that, so that people can be able to identify.
There is already a process for developing a toolkit.